Just might as well tell you now. I'm going to... We are in Rome.
The hint was in the Lego store in Florence. I made sure to pan over the Colosseum Lego set. So if you got that, kudos to you. But yeah, we're in Rome, baby. Gonna be here for 2 days. 2 nights, that is. Today, first stop is we're going to the Vatican City to add another country to my list of countries that I visited. So we're gonna go ahead over there. And it was raining whenever I got here, but it's died down since then, and hopefully it's gonna be at least somewhat nice the rest of the day. But I came prepared today, this time. So we're just gonna head over there and let's go.
So as you guys can tell, it is super packed here, so I don't think we're going to be able to make it into the St. Peter's Basilica, which is kind of a bummer, but I've seen a lot of cathedrals on my trip, so I'm not too bummed about it. But next up is we're going to the Vatican Museums, and we're going to spend some time there. So yeah, we're just going to head over there. And then it's a skip the line tour, so we aren't gonna have to wait in line or anything, which is gonna be really, really nice. So I'll see you guys over there, and let's go. Alright, so I just got to the Vatican Museums. I booked it with a skip the line tour. It's a self-guided tour, so I'm actually not going with anyone, but I was able to skip the whole line. You guys saw outside that it was crazy. So definitely if you ever come here for anything that's not free, like obviously I couldn't do it for St. Peter's Basilica since it's a cathedral and it's free here, instead of like the Westminster Abbey and all that other stuff that had tickets. But yeah, so if you ever come here and anything that's not free, book a tour or something that can get you in easily, because otherwise you're gonna be waiting for hours and hours and hours, and it's not gonna be fun. It'll be like just like going to like Disney World or something and only getting to see like one or two rides in a day. But yeah, so now that we're in here, we're going to enjoy it. And yeah, I'm gonna spend like 2 or 3 hours here. This place is like massive. There's a lot of museums within the Vatican Museum, so we're gonna tour as many as we can. And yeah, just enjoy the montage and seeing some history and some cool artwork. So let's go.
Hey, amigo, go that daddy, mamma mia, when such a do. Sette peglia lo pescia, io le isso va, isso vena, se lo pescia, maladena. Se ci ingappa la fantasia dei pescioli a vecchiuzza mia, la la riola, pesce fritta e baccalà, uè gomba, no calamara c'ha giaccata. Second stanza. C'è una luna a mezzumare, mamma mia, figlia mia, cosa dare, mamma mia, pensaccia tu. Se te piglia lo polizia, isso va, isso vena, sembra scuffetta malatena. Se ci ingappa la fantasia di scuppettia, figliuzza mia, la la riola, pesce fritta e baccalà, uè gomba, una scuppetta c'ha giaccata. And now for you nice ladies and gentlemen out there who don't understand the Italian language, I'd like to do two choruses in British. Lazy Mary, you better get up, she answered back, I am not evil. Lazy Mary, you better get up, we need the sheets for the table. Lazy Mary, you smoke in bed, there's only one man you should marry. My advice to you would be is to pay attention to me. You'd better marry a fireman, he'll come and go, go and come, zembala bomba manadena.
So just finished with the Sistine Chapel and the Vatican Museums. I couldn't record in the Sistine Chapel, but I did get a couple of pictures that I'll post right here. It was pretty cool. The whole museum took all of like, I think 2.5-3 hours to go through, but it was well worth it. Highly recommend going, and just it was cool seeing all the paintings and the carpet, whatever tapestry things. It was amazing though. I enjoyed it. Now I'm gonna go get some lunch, and then we're gonna head to the Mamertine prison, which is where they think Peter and Paul were held in prison in Rome at some point. And then we'll go on to the highlight probably of the trip, the Colosseum, and then the Palatine Hill and Roman Forum. So a lot going on today, and yeah, so I'll catch you guys over there, and peace. If I had a dollar for every Lego store I've seen in Italy, I would have $3. That's a lot of money. I got another Italian lesson for you guys. Paese che vai, usanze che trovi. That means when in Rome, do as the Romans do. Cool. Now you guys know a little bit more Italian, and I'll try to teach you some more. So let's keep exploring. Just got done touring the Colosseum. This place is epic. Definitely the highlight of the trip so far. You get to go through pretty much all of it with a standard ticket. I didn't get to go on the one section, the arena floor, and then the lower levels, and then there's like two other floors below, but you get the gist from the first and the second floor of what it looks like. But yeah, that was really cool to see. Got to see a lot of architecture, a lot of marble stonework. It looks really cool. So now we're gonna go head over to the Palatine Hill and the Roman Forum to see some even more amazing old Roman buildings and stuff. So let's go head over there. These Romans are crazy. How did they build this? This is insane. Alright y'all, I'm headed to the hotel. We're gonna get checked in, then we're gonna go have a nice dinner. So let's go.
Room tour. It's a nice bathroom. Whoa. Then bed. Ooh. Little couch thing. Another mirror. Desk. And then this is my view. Pretty much what I paid for, but that's fine. I don't even care.
So, just got back to the hotel. It's been a long day, if I'm being honest. Got a lot done today. Really, the only thing that didn't go as planned was seeing St. Peter's Basilica, but yeah, we'll just have to leave that for next trip. But for dinner, I went to this place. It was like a pizzeria place type thing. I had a salad and this thing called supli, which is rice balls with mozzarella fried. It's really good. It was on my recommendation to try from someone else, so I tried it and it was really good. I also had salad and then gnocchi. I still don't know how to pronounce it. I should know how to, but I don't. But yeah, that was really good. And then I had a mushroom pizza, which was really nice too. The pizza I had was a lot thinner than most like American pizzas, and then there wasn't as much sauce, so you definitely tasted all the cheese and the mushrooms, which is really nice. But yeah, it was a really good pizza. The pasta was handmade as well, and that was really cool. And yeah, then afterwards I went and got some gelato. Also, if you're ever in Italy, get the Fork. It's an app. I'm not sponsored in any way, but I got 50% off my food tonight because I made a reservation through them. And honestly, when you're going to Italy, you have to make reservations because a lot of restaurants can't guarantee, especially on the weekends, that you'll be able to go there. So yeah, just a little tip, recommendation. But yeah, I am so tired. Let me check my step count real quick. Well, we blew our London Day 2 record out of the water with 38,630 steps and basically 21 and a half miles walked. So I did a lot of walking today. Tomorrow's all free, except I have a reservation for the Pantheon. Wait. Yeah, the Pantheon. At 2 p.m. Then I also have dinner reservations. But other than that, I have nothing else planned tomorrow. So we're literally just going to walk around the city. We're going to eat. We're going to have a lot of fun. Hopefully it's not too boring for y'all. I'm going to try to make it interesting. But yeah, so this is Paul signing off for another day, another adventure, and I'll see you guys in the morning.
If this video gets to 3 likes, then I will do the griddy at a World Wonder. Ooh, which World Wonder are you going to, Paul?
I say right foot creep. Ooh.
Look at this dude.
Look around, stay low, make sure they don't see. I'm literally hitting the griddy at the Coliseum.